Hey, this is Ben, HotDogCartStore.com and LearnHotDogs.com, and I'm coming to you to do a cart critique, a hot dog vendor location critique, and it's all about my good location is bad. I did a video yesterday where I gave you all the different steps on what you can fix and what you can't fix if you have a good location that is performing bad. And usually, though, it's all fixable, and in this case, it is the same. This is a fixable deal, and I'm going to show you how that gets done. Now let's zoom in here. Okay, so here we are at this vendor's location. We're looking right down on it, and I'm gonna pull. Let's do this. I'm gonna see if I can. I think, yeah, there we go. I want you to look at it at an angle like this. Okay, so this is his location. And he has got a heck of a good area to do this location. He's, you know, from all outside perception of this location, it's ideal. He's in the heart of town. There's easy access from several points. Let me get out my marker set here so I can draw some for you. He's got an access point here. He's got an access point here. If they missed him, they can go all the way around and come right back into the parking lot and then go back on their way wherever they needed to go, right? So this is really an ideal setup. Now, this vendor is located right here, right in this parking lot, I think actually right about here. So, and I'll show you pictures of that here in just a second. But that's where this vendor is located. And this is just, it seems like a prime spot. You know, you've got business here that can bring you business. Plus you have this easy road, okay? And I don't know the speed of the traffic, but either way, you've got traffic coming all different directions around this place. And he's got a swooper flag here. And I'll show you that swooper flag in a minute, and that way to give you an idea of where that's located. So we know that, I'm going to do this again for you. He's here, and swooper flag is here. And now I'm going to show you, let me pull this up real quick. Let's see. Okay, let me get rid of my dots. Here's his location from right out in front on the road, looking towards the store. Okay, swooper flag would be over in this direction, okay? Over to the left. Now I want to show you his setup. His setup is clean. There's a swooper flag. So you can see a swooper flag here. He's got a clean location. He's got a nice menu board with his prices. And he's got a clean setup. He's easily seen from the road. Now, here is another view of this to give you, let me get rid of my little marker there. Okay, that is the view out front. This is a view from across the street at the intersection. And then here is a view, let's see if I can find this other view. I think that, there we go. That's the one I was looking for. I want you to look at this. So there's a swooper flag. This is probably the primary area people are traveling down. They see the sign, they pull in here, and he's getting business. Okay, don't get me wrong. He's getting business. So they're coming down and coming around here and into the parking lot and buying hot dogs right there. But you can see how this, even from the photo view, and we're not far away from him, it's hard to tell what's going on. You do have this swooper flag, which is great. That's smart. It's a 15-foot high swooper flag. And that's smart to have. We recommend it. But something I talked about in the video yesterday, my good location is bad. One of the things, and this is the case here, one of the things that this vendor could do to solve his problems, one thing is a sign. Okay? Just one sign. And now, I would prefer more signs, but I'm going to tell you one sign. Here's his swooper flag, okay? And then again, I'm going to show you where he's located. I'll put an X there where he is. Here is where the swooper flag is. Now, could he have a sign right about here, somewhere in this area, okay? And I'll put a dot there that said, "Hot all beef hot dogs, $2 or $3, whatever his price is." That gives them time, right? And then it could say next right, or hot dogs, next right. Fresh hot dogs, next right. That way they know they can pull in here and get a hot dog. The sign will throw, you know, that'll tell them immediately. So they'll see this first, then they'll come down here and see the hot dog sign. They'll pull in and get a hot dog. He is missing, probably because he's not doing that well at this location. He's missing people because they get all the way down here. They get up here in this area. They can read hot dogs, okay? They see him off over here to the side, which is quite a ways. I showed you, and we were looking from about here. It wasn't that good of a an ideal spot, basically. He's in a good spot, but what my point is by the time they figure it out, they're almost past this, right? And so I would have something here to emphasize what's coming. Now, I'm sure you've heard of bandit signs. And if you're old, like me, you've heard of Burma Shave. In the 1950s, Burma Shave, a shaving cream company, came out with bandit signs. I think they were the first people ever to come out with bandit signs. They had these signs on the interstate like this one, okay? But they always had a story to tell, okay? So they'd have one sign, and then about 100, maybe 200 yards up, they'd have another, and then another, but they told a story in a sequence, or they told a poem, or they advertised. They weren't even trying to get you to turn in anywhere. They were just trying to get your attention. So next time you were in the dollar, well, it was back then a five and dime store, they'd want you to pick up Burma Shave. So they had signs like this: "Within this veil of toil and sin, your head grows bald, but not your chin." They've got one that said, here's a sequence here: "No lady likes to snuggle or dine accompanied by a porcupine. Burma Shave." This was down the highway. This would be a picture of the last sign in a sequence. These are called bandit signs, and they're brilliant. I've used them. I love them. In fact, it saved my tire location in the beginning because that's what I did. My dad told me, he goes, "Why don't you put out a bandit sign?" And I was like, "Okay, what do you mean?" And he goes, "Go get you some of them cheap wire real estate signs or yard sale stakes. You know, they're like a dollar each. Get you some of that Coroplast, put vinyl letters on it or draw on it with a magic marker. And you put that on there, and then you make a story." Okay, it doesn't have to be cutesy and funny, but it could say, you could do it cutesy and funny, and your business would just, you know, multiply. But what you could do is put up something like, let me go back to the picture here so you can see where I'm talking about. I would have something like here, and then I would have something here, and something here, and something here. Maybe a four, in one sentence, four signs. Don't miss it. And I'm telling you what I'd put, you know, or kind of what I'd put. Don't miss it. All beef, hot dogs, turn right. You know, you could put more signs, but it's signs that he can take up at the end of the day. He's only out there for a couple or 3 hours. So why not put up some signs that say, two dogs, drinks, chips, $7. And I don't know his price, but let's say it was $7 for the value meal. Turn right, right here. Okay? So now you're leading them in here. But then I would go a step further, because some people are going to miss it anyway. It's just going to happen. There's no way around it. Some people are going to miss it. I'd come here and put one, and I'd put one, and I'd put one. Well, this one would actually be right here. Okay? Then I'd put one here. So here's what I would say on these. OMG, turn right now. Or it's not too late. Hot dogs, best hot dogs of your life. I mean, you can think of a blue million things to say. Turn right now or make a right and then have a picture of a hot dog. Make a right here again, picture of a hot dog. Next right, you're here, okay? Or an arrow, you're here, you know, pointing them in this direction. So now he's capitalizing on entertaining them a little bit, and then he's capitalizing on the missed traffic and gets them back in here. But then he's also got this, okay? This is, these people are already paying money. They're already here. They're already established. People know where they are. People are walking in and out of here, and I don't know how many during his lunch hours that they're coming in and out. But why wouldn't you have something on the door or feed the employees in here and go, hey, give them this coupon when they check out. And the coupon says, bring your receipt over to the hot dog man and you get a free bag of chips with any purchase. Or you get a free drink. Or you get your second dog's on us. You know, anything like that. And you could have a sign or you could have the employees doing it. You'd have to talk to the manager, but they probably like it because it makes somebody who's spent money have proof of a receipt to come over here to your cart. Huge volume of business here. Even if all this wasn't here, you should have enough business here. But with combined with both of these, you've got a business. I mean, this should be a $300, $400, $500, $600 a day location, period. So that's all I'm going to say. That's all you got to do is change that. If you want to test it, I show you how to test an area that will guarantee that I'm right in making these little changes that are instant, that will work instantly for you and make you more money, double, triple, and quadruple your income at any good location. So here's a good location that wasn't doing that good. We're going to fix that, and I'll let you know how that comes out. But I thank you for watching this critique. I hope you'll go over to learnhotdogs.com and get your learn on. You can type in keywords. You're struggling with something. You want to know about lemonade. You want to know about cotton candy. You want to know about something you can add to your cart. You want to know about a commissary. You want to know about a license. You want to know about some restriction a city told you about. I've got it for you at learnhotdogs.com. I thank you for joining me, and I'll see you next time.